The closing value of Sensex for the month of October 2007 is given below. Date closing, Sensex value. So many days. Again, it looks like so much is there. I'll tell you the technique. You are required to test the weak form of efficient market. Means whether weak or not. That's all we have to tell. When do you tell if it is weak? You tell weak when it is where you can predict. We have only price now. We don't have any other information. Now using the price, can you predict or not? We will do test now. If you can predict, that means market exhibits weak form of efficiency. If it is not within the prediction, then we say market is not weak. We don't say strong. Strong means different. So we just say whether it is weak or not weak. That's all our comment. And they are telling value at T, 10%, 5%, degrees of freedom. That is statistical distribution. We have normal distribution, binomial distribution, Poisson distribution, chi square, T distribution. So many are there. But for this, what is relevant is T distribution. I'll just tell you what is the meaning of this 5%, 10%. We will be using it later also. But just give you an idea. You know, in all these, this is not my example. Somebody was telling in the YouTube, so I adopted there. Whenever you see these advertisements, soap advertisement, especially now, they say we kill 99% of the germs. Nobody can tell 100%. What is it, 1%? Risk is always there. Similarly, when we are doing testing, I cannot tell 100% my test is right. 90% my test might be right. Or 95% my test might be right. The error levels is what I'm calling it as. This 5% or 10%. These are called as level of significance. That is a technical name. Errors is correct. But technical name is level of significance. How much confidence you can give. And when we do testing, I will not predict, okay, market will be this number. We can only predict it will be within this range. We need a range to compute. If the market is falling within that range, market is weak. If market is outside that range, then market is not weak. We can't say strong. So for range, how do we compute the range? One number, we should do plus one number and we should do minus one number. That's how we get the lower range and we get the upper range. For that range only, they have given this information. Let's see how to analyze. Degrees of freedom means how many variables will have an impact. For example, if I tell you average marks of 5 students is some number and for 4 students I'll give you marks, can you compute the fifth student's marks? 5 students average I'll tell you, 4 students individual mark I'll tell you. Can you find out balancing figure the last students? You don't require. You can compute because we know the average. That means whenever 5 people are there, 1 person is independent. You don't have to depend on him to compute your numbers. That is called as degrees of freedoms. When number of observations are there, how many numbers are required to do analysis? So we usually subtract 1. It's like if you have 5 friends group, if 4 people tell one thing, one person has to follow it. No other choice. So that's what we tell, but formula will change slightly. I'll come to that point. We'll change slightly, but degrees of freedom meaning is that. Statistical meaning is that. So first thing what you have to do, what you're trying to analyze here. We are trying to analyze whether market will go up or market will come down. So what you should do every day, just tell me whether market is going up or coming down. That's all you should tell me. I don't want how much. Just the direction. Plus or minus. First day it is 2800 to 2780. So it is minus. 2780 to 2795. Plus. 2795 to 2830. Plus. 2830 to 2760. Minus. Like that. You complete. It looks like some game you are doing. Some children will play game like this. You complete the whole table. Plus, minus, plus, minus. That's all. Increasing is plus. decreasing is minus. Just complete the table. That's your choice, wherever you want. Exam you can't do it, but now you can do anywhere. Maybe you can write again, so it will save time. In exam, you have to repeat the question and solve it. Because even if you look at the chart, you may not be able to see. Look at the solution, you can't see because so many are there. You have to do correct numbers, correct identifications. And also write clearly, because some people's plus also, minus also looks like same thing. Just be very, very clear. Okay, just as a verification, just count how many positive signs are there and how many negative signs are there. Just count so that we can verify our answers. Number of positive signs 11 and number of negative signs 8. That is what is called as N1 and N2. Market going up so many times, market coming down so many times. So write these things. This is what is going to be used now. This table is no longer used. Only this much only is required. Number of positive changes, number of negative changes. Yeah, N1, N2. Correct. Okay. Okay, next one is important. Many students don't know this. This, so for some people, it's complicated. It's called as number of test runs. We just say N. For this, what you should identify, this is important. You did minus plus plus minus, that is market up, market down. How many times the market changed its direction? Meaning, if it is minus, then becoming minus, the direction is not changed. But minus becoming plus, there is a change. And plus continues to be plus, no change. Plus again change, plus, no change. But that plus becomes minus, there is a change. So how many times there is a change in direction? You have to count. And the first one also you count as one. That is, this also you count. So minus is becoming plus, so that is second. Plus, plus, the plus becoming minus, that is third, and minus becoming plus once more. Then plus, 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 plus becoming minus once, minus remaining minus, no problem, but minus becoming plus once, the plus becoming minus once more, minus, 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 that minus becoming plus at the last. So totally you get 8. That is called as number of test runs where the direction is changed. Please highlight also, because later you don't know which number you have applied. Okay, so now we are going to, we need a range. I told you, only when we know a range, we can know the estimation whether market is weak or not. For that, we have one formula called as mu, average. This is nothing but average. This formula you have to buy heart. This is given by statistics. So statistical derivations and all, we are not going. That's two for one problem. That's not worth it. So mu equals 2n1 n2 by n1 plus n2. n1 n2 we calculated. Number of positive signs, number of negative signs. Simplify. you should get 10.26. Okay, we have computed the mean, but we require the range. Range means mu, that is average. We need to do plus or minus one number. Plus number to get the upper level, minus number to get the lower level. Then only we get the range. That number is called as standard deviation. That is average plus or minus standard deviation. Standard deviation will tell you the range. Upper how much, lower how much. So you should apply this formula. Only n1, n2, nothing else. Use this formula. N1 is 11, n2 is 8, and simplify how much this standard deviation comes to. Average, mu. This is standard deviation. This is average. This is standard deviation. So numerator is 176 into 157, denominator 19 square and 18. And you know how to calculate this in calculator faster. 176 into 157 divided by 19, divided by 19, divided by 18. Square means 2 times. So divided by 19, divided by 19, divided by 18. Then square root. That is 2.06. So mu we have, that is average we have 10.26, and for range we have 2.06. Okay, so we got this number 10.26 and 2.06. This is mean and this is standard deviation. The thing is, we don't stop only with mean and standard deviation. We need one more thing. What are the chances? That is called as probability. Because it depends on your level of significance, probability value will change. That probability values are given by the problems that are degrees of freedom so much. So we have to make use of it. We'll do that. So the formula for ranges is this: mu minus t into standard deviation and mu plus t into standard deviation. So one lower range, I mean lower value, one upper value. The t is basically trying to help you with probability. What is chance that this will happen as per t distribution table? So at 5% level of significance. 5% level of significance means like this. If you draw a graph, like how many times it happens, looks like graph, I think. This is extreme minus infinity plus infinity. So this, when you do mistake, mistake can happen on left extreme. or mistake can happen on right extremes. That is, if you tell my average marks likely to be in C exam is 60 marks, but 5% of the times it can be more than 75 also, and 5% of the times it can be less than 5 also. People are there who score like that, but very less number of percentages. But mostly people will be around this average. So this extreme percentage, that is what is errors. That is what is concluded in the level of significance. Anyway, don't worry about it too much on that aspects. So what you need to consider, what is the degrees of freedom? I told you one less, but we have N1 and we have N2. So we should do N1 plus N2 minus 2. That is the number of variables which are with freedom, degrees of freedom. So N1 plus N2 minus 2 means, is it 18 correct? What is number of this one? 7, sorry, no, this is not 2, it's 1 only. So number of people minus 1, you just subtract 1, sorry, not 2. N1 plus N2 minus 1, so that's my mistake. N1 plus N2 minus 1, when number of variables are there, 1 is dependent. That person is taken out. So N1 plus N2 minus 1, 18 degrees of freedom. So what is the, so many numbers they have given, which number is appropriate? 5% significance, 18 degrees of freedom. What is the t value in the question they have given? Ideally, we should use t distribution table, but they will give it in the question itself. What is the appropriate number? 5%, 18 degrees of freedom means t value equals 2.101. So that number you substitute. 2.101 and here also 2.101. That will give you the range. So what is the lower range you are telling? 5.9. Upper range is 14.588. Okay. And we have found out one thing which we have not used so far. That is number of test runs. How much is that? 8. Now this is our range. Our range of estimation is 5.9 to 14, and what is the number of test runs is 8. Is it within the range? It is within the range. So that means we say market is weak. We are able to predict the range. If you're able to predict the range, market is weak in price. Volume we don't know. So that's why we say it exhibits weak form of efficiency. It is within the range. If it was not 8, if it was 15, it is outside the range. Then we say market does not exhibit weak form of efficiency. Does not mean strong. It can only mean semi-strong, then comes to strong. So at this point, you should keep it in mind. It is exhibiting weak form of efficiency at 5% level of significance. When we have to use price also, volume also, and we have to use other data, even then we cannot predict the price. All points are used, even then the range cannot be predicted. That means market is efficient. No, so in the weak form, because we have three levels. In this level, it is not weak. But next level, I can't use the word strong, because strong means I should not only use price, I should use volume also, other data also. So we say if it is outside 15, we say market does not exhibit weak. So we don't say weak strong, we say weak or not weak. Because next layer we have to move further. and then you can write that line, market does not exhibit, in this case, sorry, market exhibits, because within the range. So you can write at 5%, market exhibits weak form of efficiency. At 5%, market exhibits weak form of efficiency. Weak form. The efficiency is very, very weak. Weak form of efficiency. What about 10%? Different number you get. Try it out. So you get, 6.68 and 13.8. So here also it is within the range. So same sentence you can repeat. At 5% also market exhibits weak form of efficiency. Same sentence. At 10% also market exhibits weak form of efficiency. It came in the exam only one time. I really don't think it will come. But anyway, we have prepared. Okay, so this is a security analysis. So comparatively, from exam point of view, fundamental analysis is more important. Technical analysis is very, very less. Because technical analysis is too much. People have so many charts, so many formulas, so many patterns. So we are not becoming traders. We don't look at much here. But I told you three sides in analysis, if you remember on that workshop. One was fundamental. One was technical and another was portfolio. That is important, which we'll take it up next.